Now Gabriel didn't need to use sat-nav. He knew exactly where he'd find Mary, kneeling by her bed saying her prayers. Mary's eyes were shut tight, but suddenly it didn't seem dark anymore. She blinked and looked. The angel Gabriel, dressed in white, standing in the corner. Mary gasped.
Mary gasped again.
Mary thought about what Gabriel was saying. She felt so deeply that many minutes passed. Finally, she looked up into Gabriel's kind face. His eyes blazed like diamonds.
Eventually, he fell fast asleep and the angel spoke to him in his dream. Suddenly, he woke up and had an answer.
The emperor has said that everyone's name must be put on a very big list. Everyone is to register their hometowns. When Joseph heard this, he felt bad news.
Poor me, my hometown Bethlehem. It's such a long way away. But when he discovered that Mary was going to come back this time, he would have to come and he sat down and cried. Why does it have to be like this, God?
When they arrived in Bethlehem, the town was full of people, too busy to notice them. Suddenly, Mary felt her baby jump in her womb. She knew they must find shelter quickly, but where? Joseph tried all the lodging houses, but nobody could help. Then he saw a light of an inn down the dingy back alley. Maybe there would be a small room there. But the man who answered Joseph's knock shook his head. Joseph thought all was lost and whispered to Mary.
All Mary could do was pray. Maybe that the angel would return and light up a dark spot underneath her head.
Because very soon, Mary's baby was born. Mary placed Jesus in the cradle and it was as if all the darkness had gone and everywhere looked warm and cosy. Even the animal sounds were comforting.
An angel Gabriel came past the
door. On the hill outside Bethlehem, shepherds had been watching their sheep. Hungry wolves hid in the shadows and sheep made them a tasty supper. It was cold and demanding work and nobody wanted to do it. The village folk called them names and avoided the shepherds because they often smelt.
Suddenly, the sky grew light and Gabriel appeared. The light was so bright that the shepherds had to hide their eyes. They were so scared, but then they heard a voice saying,
"Today in Bethlehem, God's son has been born. He will be a great and glorious God, and have been a peace and a praise to everyone."
The shepherd flee and rubs their eyes. It was such a wonderful sight. The whole sky has come alive and the stars shone like diamonds. It was a heavenly firework display, and then everywhere felt silent and calm. Good news. The shepherds sang songs of joy as they rushed down to greet the baby Jesus.
It started when they heard a strange noise outside. Joseph peeped out and said,
"Mary, you are never going to believe this. There are camels out there and men. They are dressed in beautiful clothes. They look like kings."
Mary tried to do a quick tidy up, but it was too late. Before Joseph and Mary could say anything at all, their wealthy visitors were kneeling down in front of Jesus, offering him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. It was such a happy celebration. What wonderful gifts to bring. Good news.
Was born to be our light in the dark of this world. Good news.
Thank you. angels.